From the UK to the USA.
Gone after the whole Mayhem squad, man, all the way from North Carolina.
It's the Friday Mayhem Clubhouse Show with Anthony B and Mr. Carlos.
We don't mess about here. Hey! How you doing? Yes, how are you? And you know the thing about it? The first thing I've got to say is this. You're not Brent Carter, are you? Because that's your name underneath.
That's
your name. Like, no, I'm not. Kiandra Richardson.
Hey,
yeah, we're cool. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. Yeah. Do you know this is one thing we do with all our artists? Here we go. Here's your
just
intro.
An old better
it's time for another hot interview.
Actress and soul artist Kiandra Richardson.
Yay!
I tell you what, man, I tell you, this is just what we do in the UK, man. We're the best show. I'm not gonna lie. Aren't we the best show, Carlos?
We're not bad at all.
We're not bad at all. Yeah. How are you, Kiandra? How are you?
I am well.
Yeah, you look well. Oh, you look well.
I was gonna say, she looks well, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Oh my god,
really so long.
It's so good seeing you again.
I know, it's good to see you.
It's been so many years. Like,
it has.
That's my baby right there. Oh my god.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, we'll go there later.
We're blessed to have such talented actresses and soul artists like yourself.
Really
is most appreciated for coming on the
Absolutely.
Show. Do you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna play you singing I think it's Whitney Houston on Empire. Yeah, and then we're gonna come into a conversation. Was it Whitney Houston? I think it was. Yeah. Take a listen to this, right? Here we go.
Okay.
Through the motions, cause there ain't no other way. I swear that I can feel you. Don't know if I'm asleep or awake. I reach out to touch you, then realize you're miles away. And every chance I took for granted, never again. I won't let you go. I'm like a heart without a soul, so I'll count down the days and try not to.
And now more, hey!
Yeah, that was lovely.
That was just deep,
that
deep,
was lovely.
Deep.
Thank you. I haven't heard that song in a while. I was like, oh, right, I forgot. About this.
Yeah, I saw you rocking in the green behind the scenes. I saw you rocking, nodding your head. That's me, man. That's me.
That is
so
wow, amazing.
So, Kiandra, how are you? Did you have a good week, by the way? Have a good week?
I have had a wonderful week. I've had a wonderful week, actually. I know everything is like, I'm well, I'm wonderful, but I really am, though. If you see me fanning, it's like a little fruit fly that just keeps flying around. So forgive me.
Yeah. Just ruining your train of thought.
Right. I'm like, can you go
I
away?
Can see it. I want to talk about Empire. I mean, how did you actually get that part in Empire?
God. And that's really how that happened. Because I wouldn't even be able to tell you how that kind of came about. I know I was singing and doing the music thing in LA, and randomly I got an email from the casting director of Empire or one of the casting directors. And she was like, hey, can you tape for this? And I was like, sure, you know? So I taped for it. And then they ended up reaching back out and saying, hey, the producers like you. and they want you for the role. And I literally said, are you sure? Good.
Me?
I was like, really? And she was like, yeah. And my face was like, for maybe 30 seconds, 30 seconds, my mouth was wide open because I just couldn't, it just happened so randomly and so effortlessly. And I was like, oh, wow. Mm. And so I always say God is how that happened.
Yeah. And what seasons was it? Was it season 5, 6?
Season
what?
Six.
Season six. Okay.
Season six.
Okay.
When you came on, I was like, when I was
that's
like,
my girl.
I was like, wait, what? Yeah.
Right.
Oh man.
I was like, that is amazing. That song. Yeah. I listened to that song like tons of times. It just brings tears to my eyes. You're so talented.
Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
I knew that was gonna happen.
You know, okay, you called it.
Yeah. Do you know, we're just blessed to have talented actresses and singers like yourself.
Yeah.
Do you know, Cinnamon's gonna give me a vocal lesson only for like a minute and two, and Kiandra, I can't sing, but I guarantee by the end of this show, I'm gonna sound like Jodeci. No, maybe not Jodeci, not the way they are now. Oh,
sorry, mate. But, did you say Jodeci?
Back in the day, Jodeci, not now, Jodeci. Because I've seen them recently. It's not good, man. It's not good. I'm not going to lie.
Talking about Boy George, my friend.
What do you mean, Boy George? My voice ain't like Boy George. Listen, we could go for hours. It's not about us. It's about you, Kiandra.
It takes more than a minute. You can ask Kiandra that. You know, it takes more than a lot of training we went through.
It takes
Hey, let me tell you, Cinnamon, do you know who I am? I'm going to learn within 1 minute. I'm telling you now.
Okay. Hey, you can do all things. So, hey.
Or 1 hour.
We're going to put you to that challenge.
Okay.
How did you link up with Cinnamon? How did that all come about?
Wow. Okay. So I was 18 years old and I was working with a woman named Drexena Nelson. She had kind of taken me up under her wing and she was managing me at the time. And she put me with producers. And then the producer that we were working with, his name is Ish. Well, we call him Ish. I don't know if he goes by that now, but
Jamin.
Yeah, Jamin James. we were working together and he introduced us to Cinnamon. And I met Cinnamon, and when I tell you Cinnamon had me going, she had me going. I learned.
Is she a hard taskmaster? Or is she just nice?
Very much so. She's going to get it out of you is what it is. She's going to get it.
Okay. She's going to find it, even if it's not there.
Like, yeah. She's going to get what she needs to get out of you.
Yeah.
And it's good. Crazy the difference when you listen to things before her and then things after her, like recordings that I've done. Absolutely. And I'll say this, I definitely learned with Cinnamon how important the core is in singing, right?
Yeah. You can tell.
Of course, they say, you know, use your diaphragm, so forth, so on.
But the
core is so vital to that. You have to have a strong core to be able to power with the diaphragm and to get these notes out. And I didn't know that until I met her. And so from then on, intact.
Listen, funny you say that. Your definition.
The song she sang for me when she first came to me through Ish, she sang Dangerously in Love, right?
Yes.
And, you know, and so a lot of singers, and I'm just going to say this, a lot of singers that sing like her, and, you know, and the Shamaris and, you know, a lot of people have a natural gift.
Very talented.
Them to the next level, it's like, okay, you can do this, but now let's go here.
Right.
And I got you.
Dangerously in Love, remember? And I had her going to the rafters, like teaching her about her resonance voice. She was like, I did not know I could do that. You know?
Right.
And I would have her dancing constantly and singing and dancing. And it worked.
It seems like you always have a great relationship. Listen, as I mentioned earlier on, you know, when I watched Encore and on BET, and when you kind of came into the room, you know, Shamari, she hugged you and everything. And it just seems like you have a good relationship with everybody that you work with. Is that correct, Kiandra? Or do I need to take Cinnamon off the off the screen?
Don't take her off. It's a spirit thing. It's a spirit thing. And what was I reading? It was something where you can always tell a tree by the fruit it bears, right?
Yeah.
Love and that. So if you're looking at all of her relationships and you're seeing that everyone is like, Cinnamon, you know.
That's right.
It should tell you a lot about the spirit of the person. And Cinnamon has a wonderful spirit. I know I'm talking like you're not right here, but, you know, she has a wonderful spirit and it shows up. She's just serious about what she does. And it reflects clearly because, you know, we're all doing.
You're going to make her cry. You're going to make her cry. I can see it.
She's
crying. She's crying already.
I'll cry too.
Yeah, sorry, Cinnamon, I'm gonna have to bring you up. No, maybe not. I don't want to see you cry. But it just shows. I mean, Cinnamon's really kind of well in with all the artists that she works with, what you're blessed. Sorry,
Carlos. Even with the time in which we've known you, we can see that you're a great character. You've got a warm and inviting spirit. Yes. You know, and you're lovely to talk to. And we've seen that element in your daughter that came on earlier on. We're seeing it with this young lady here. And,
Top
you know,
actress.
even down to the training and preparing for the gym workout. I was going to say earlier on that I could see her physique, even there, that her muscle tone, that she's continued doing.
He goes to the gym.
I said,
I will
not fail. Once I figure it out, we got to keep this core together. It was a thing. Then
what she taught you, you can see it, you know.
Yeah.
And what I was going to say, you know, going on to the next question, I was going to say to you, how old was you when you realized that this was the career that you wanted to get into?
Yeah.
At what age would you say, you know what, I want to be a singer?
Mm. Okay. So when I said I wanted to be a singer, I was five years old.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
It was the 1994. Whitney Houston's concert for New South Africa. My mom had that on VHS and she would watch it like over and over and over again. And we knew that concert back and forth, up and down, side to side. And when I saw that at five, I'm singing it and I'm looking at this woman and I'm like, oh, this is what I'm going to do in my life.
Okay.
So you've got all these kids watching Sesame Street, right?
Yeah.
And you're watching Whitney Houston in South Africa at five. Come on. That's amazing.
They're watching
Sesame
and
Street.
And Barney. I'm watching Barney.
I did love Barney now.
I could tell you're a Barney person. I love Barney.
That's
amazing. You know, I was gonna say, well, you kind of touched on how you met Cinnamon, so I presume is that when you got your big break or did that come afterwards?
So I'm still, in my opinion, I'm still kind of waiting for the, not even waiting, but just
no, you're there, man.
I have yet to experience, to me, the big break. I've been awarded opportunities, or I've been given opportunities to act and to sing and to tour and to do a lot of really cool things, but I'm still expecting a big break.
Well, you're big enough, man. You're big enough.
How things are going.
I mean, listen, you're on a big break anyway.
Yeah.
I'll tell you the reason why you're on a big break, because you're on the Mayhem Clubhouse show.
Okay.
That's a big enough break for you, yeah? You ain't going to get bigger than this.
I think that there are so many singers that are talented out here who have not had the opportunity to do the things that you have done.
Correct.
And I mean, it's a huge break. It's not a big break. It's a huge break because even after we parted, because you left and went back to Cali, you know, and next thing I knew, you were playing Whitney Houston on the road. I was like, what?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh my gosh.
What was that like for you playing Whitney Houston? Isn't it her 60th? 60th, isn't it?
I think it may be coming up.
Coming up, yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, it is. Birthday. What was that like for you?
That was really challenging, but fun. Of course, like I said, I have been watching her for a long time. And Whitney Houston is someone that all of us know and love, and people don't play about Whitney, right? So if you're going to step into those types of shoes, you need to be able to come with it, or else they're going to drag you through the mud.
Yeah.
And so that's the part that was, you know, nerve-wracking. But once I kind of got out of that mindset of it all, someone told me, her name is Nita Whitaker. She was like, nobody is asking you to be Whitney Houston.
Okay.
We just want to feel her essence. And right. I was like, oh yeah, I don't have to go out here and be Whitney. Whitney was already Whitney. All I have to do is bring the truth and the essence of Whitney to this show. And so it was after that, it was a fun time just diving into Whitney, the icon, and Whitney, the person. You know, what are her fears? Mm. What are her goals? What does she want? What didn't she have? You know, and tapping into that, because then you start to relate to her as a human, and you don't have to worry about trying to be this icon. You know what I'm saying?
Can I ask, is it?
Yeah, go on.
Do we have time for her to sing just a little bit of the Whitney?
Woo!
I think that'd be amazing.
Because we're coming to the end anyway.
Okay, real. Yeah. Oh my God.
Which one do you want to do? Just anyone?
I don't know.
Whatever you feel the inspiration to sing right now.
And if you want to do a duet with me, just feel free. Just let me know.
You gotta have the lesson first, and then we do the duet.
Okay. You can tell I can't sing. Okay. All right.
Okay. Let's see. Can you guys hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you loud and clear.
I love the Lord. He heard my cry and pitied every groan. Long as I live, and troubles rise, I'll hasten to. To his throne.
Listen, man, I've got to take my hat off. Yep. That was great.
I was going to come in at the end, and I said, forget it.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was great. Brilliant. That
amazing.
Was
amazing.
Yeah. That
you
was
said
great.
I put you on the spot, so you know. All of my students know I will put them on the spot sometimes because that shows the true artist. It separates you from the true artist to
the levels. It's levels. I always say this to Mr. Carlos, there's levels.
100%.
And your level is high.
Really high.
Very, very high. We're blessed.
Thank you.
To just have talented people like you. Honestly, we really do mean that because
that was beautiful.
You know, we started this about a couple of years ago and we just wanted to just have fun. And now from there, where we was to where we are now, and having such talented actresses and artists like you coming on, it really is a blessing for myself and Cinnamon as well, everybody.
And that's no pressure for Shamari. None at all.
Nah, Shamari's
cool. We know Shamari's
cool.
She's going to come on, and she's going to demonstrate that she can deliver.
No, she's got vocals. She's got vocals, man. Okay. I'm going to play something. She's fire. Okay, but listen, just wrapping up now, Carlos, you got one more question?
Thank you.
Yeah,
I'd say thank you. Yeah. And we look forward to having you on the show again at some point.
Yeah, do you want to be our co-host next? Do you want to be one of our co-hosts?
I might have to go to a training class for that first.
No, you'd be all right, man. You'd be all right.
It's my first time, and I'm absolutely loving it.
That's wonderful.
So, you know, we won't bite. We do have one more question.
They're amazing.
What's next for you, Kiandra?
Well, I have the second season of a show that I'm on called Kingdom Business on BET is coming out soon. So if you haven't watched it, go get caught up on season one, and then season two will be out, and then you can just kind of sail on through. Okay. So that's what's going on, and hopefully some music soon.
Okay. All right. Well, we are absolutely blessed in having you on. Thank you so much. Just been a wealth of stars coming on today. We're just blessed. Thank you, Cinnamon.
Thank you, Kiki.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kiki. Listen, we love you, Kiki. We love you.
Thank you. Love you guys. Bye.
You're gonna be one of our co-hosts. You said yes. It's too late. It's too late. Okay. We got you.
All right. Talk to you guys.
No problem.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. So this is the Mayhem Clubhouse Show with the boys.
Thanks for watching the Friday Mayhem Clubhouse Show. We will see you soon.
Click on the bell and subscribe to the Friday Mayhem Clubhouse Show channel.